Hello everyone, this is Nirmalendra Nirmal. In the last session we had talked about the properties of the whole numbers. Okay, we are talking about the chapter natural number and whole numbers. So in the last session we have talked about the properties of the whole numbers. Okay, for the subtraction. So we have learned about the properties of whole numbers for the subtraction and addition. And today we are going to learn about the properties of the whole numbers for multiplication. So first property is closure property. What is this? What does it say? Actually, if x and y are two whole numbers, okay, x and y are two whole numbers, then x into y, it means the product of those two whole numbers is also a whole number. If you take any two whole numbers, if you will suppose any two whole numbers, then if you get the product, then that will also be a whole number only. Let's take the example. Suppose that I've taken the whole numbers 2 and 5 here. Okay, 2 and 5 are two whole numbers. Then the product of those two whole numbers, it means 2 into 5, is equal to 10. So product we have got 10. And 10 is also a whole number. Means the product of the whole numbers is also a whole number. It means we can say that whole numbers are closed under multiplication, like addition. For the addition also the whole numbers are closed like that. The multiplication also, okay, under the multiplication also the whole numbers are closed, because the product we get the whole number only. The product of whole number is whole number. Now the second property is commutative property. If x and y are two whole numbers, if x and y are two whole numbers, then x into y is equal to y into x. If we are talking about the commutative property, it means we are talking about the order, changing of the order. If after changing the order also the result remains same, okay, result remains same even after changing the order, it means that is commutative. So we had seen that in the addition we could change the order of the numbers, okay, which does not affect the sum. So like addition, here also we can change the order in the multiplication. In place of x, y, I have written, in place of y, x. It means we can change the order of the numbers. X here I had written, what is written here? X into y, and here y into x. It means order has been changed. Even then the value remains same. Let's understand through the example. Suppose that I have taken the value, okay, x is equal to 6 and y is equal to 9. It means we have taken two whole numbers, 6 and 9. Then let's find the value of x into y. It means 6 into 9, 54. If we change the order, it means y into x. Here we have got the x into y. Now we'll find the value of y into x. And then 9 into 6, 54. So here also 54 and here also 54. We had changed the order, but we have got the same result. It means x into y is equal to y into x. Okay, it means we can change the order of the numbers in the multiplication. It means whole numbers are commutative under multiplication. Why? Because we can change the order in the multiplication. Okay, so whole numbers are commutative under multiplication. Whole numbers are commutative under the addition also, but not under the subtraction. We have studied in the previous session. Now we'll talk about the third property, associative property. If you will take any three whole numbers, then we can change the grouping of the numbers. We can change the grouping of the numbers. Even then the result will remain same. Result will be equal. It means if we are taking the three whole numbers x, y and z, then x into y into z whole of y into z is equal to x into y whole into z. It means here we have made the group of y and z, and here x and y, the numbers are same, x y and z, but here we have made the group of y and z, and here x and y, but the result remains same. We will get the same result. Let's understand through the example. Suppose that I have taken three whole numbers 4, 8 and 10. Okay, So we have to find the product of 4, 8 and 10. So we can make the group of any two whole numbers. Okay, suppose that at first we have made the group of 8 and 10. What will you get the result? 4 into 80, it means 320. Okay, 320, as I had written here, 4 into the whole of 8 into 10. Then 4 into 8 is equal to 320. So at first we had made the group of 8 and 10. Now again we will multiply, but we will change the grouping of the numbers. Now we will take another two numbers. Suppose that I am taking 4 and 8. Now let's see that what will happen with the result. 8 4 is 32 into 10. It means 320. So in this case also 4 into 10 into 10 is equal to what? We have got 320. So in both the cases, here we had made the group of 8 and 10 and here 4 and 8. Even then we have got the same result, same product. It means we can say that x into y into z whole is equal to x into y whole into z. It means they are equal. It means we can say that we can change the order of the grouping of the numbers. So the whole numbers are associative under multiplication. If we can change the order, okay, if we can change the grouping of the numbers, we can change the grouping of the numbers. It means we can say that the operation means what? Addition, subtraction, multiplication or division. Okay, if we can change the grouping of the numbers, it means that is associative. Okay, if you will not able to change the grouping of the numbers, okay, yeah, after grouping changing the grouping, the result is differing, then we will say that is not associative. Like subtraction is not associative. So we have talked about the few properties. Actually, first is closure property, second is commutative property, and third is associative. Sorry, here it should be third. Okay, so we have talked about the three properties. More properties of there whole numbers are there for multiplication. In the next session we will talk about them. So till that time, this much only. So now all of you, bye, have a nice day.